For years, underground work has been ongoing in the oil and gas sector, but with official spudding of Kingfisher oil wells due next week, Ugandans could finally tap into available opportunities. The commissioning to be officiated by the president will mean that services of local contractors plus those that have been skilled under different projects will then be required. Kingfisher is expected to produce 40,000 barrels each day. The minister was today updating the media on Uganda's oil and gas sector, key milestones of 2022, and the outlook for 2023.
And regarding the skilling of Ugandans and enterprises for business and employment opportunities, valuable partnerships have been made with private, public, and development partners. And as a result of the skilling efforts which are undertaken through these partnerships, a total of 11,021 Ugandans have been trained for the last 6 years.
The minister noted that the outlook for 2023 looks greater with the final investment decision for the refinery set for June this year. She, however, reiterated government's commitment towards environmental conservation.
We would not reach this far if we had ignored environment, health, safety, and social management. You know what civil society activists have been doing. If we had jumped any important step, we would not have reached where we have reached. But we took care of these four important aspects.
Meanwhile, Uganda will, in May this year, host the 10th East African Petroleum Conference and Exhibition.